So after he has introduced this learning methodology of a mobile planetarium, and a lot of other schools and other colleges have started using this mechanism to teach the students.
Okay.
Even he has gone beyond the schools and colleges to teach even the professionals in this of this science and technologies.
Okay.
Yep.
Very good. Very good. So, that's very good.
So, Varadarajan sir, you have been in this IT industry for more than 4 decades, and you have worked with large IT companies as well as small companies to do startups, and you have been a mentor for most of them.
Okay.
I thought today I will take this opportunity to talk about the various challenges faced by IT organizations during COVID and the post-COVID situations.
Okay. Okay. Fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
So let's have a round of talk today, and if time doesn't permit today, we can go for a second round next time, and we'll talk.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, please, Anand.
Yep. So I actually thought I will just jot down certain points for our discussions, and anyone can pick up these points and then talk about.
Okay.
And, this could be helpful in terms of focusing on certain points and then bringing out our own views for the benefit of the professionals and the IT organizations.
Okay.
So I would request Varadarajan sir, go ahead with your points, with your views.
See, the first point you have said, workload. Okay.
Right.
See, this workload is, suppose you compare a machine and a man. The machine doesn't get tired, it gets worn out. Whereas a man gets tired at the end of the day. Okay. So how are you basing your workload? That is what is very important. On base of talent, on the base of horse-like working, or how is it? They are saying 8 hours, 12 hours, 14 hours per day. Is it possible? That is what is main concern. See, I've been in that industry for a while, service industry and knowledge-based industry. More than 7 hours, everyone gets tired. More than 4 hours, mostly the slide gets into a person. Then most of the time spent in meetings. So virtually you get hardly countable time. I mean, productive, I don't use the word productivity. Countable time to service the customer becomes very small. So that takes a bit on the workload. And see, as a human being, you can't deviate or put your mind differently and come back and start working again, restart the work. That will be a major thing if somebody does it consistently and 14 hours daily.
So I can definitely read from your views that every organization facing this challenge of workload, there is always a feeling with every employee level in the organization that there is always a heavy workload. They don't have a time for their own personal activities. They don't find time for their family, time with their families and all. But what is the solution for this? Is it something that we are not looking at innovative methods which can be brought in our day-to-day process? We are not looking at the innovative tools available. We are not looking at automating our own processes, automating our own interactive methodologies, interactive documentation. All these, I think, leading to increased workload for the organization as well as at the people level. Any comment?
I would say that workload is again short of knowledge, lack of understanding of the scope of work also leads to workload. Sometimes you don't understand what exactly you have to deliver, and ultimately when you find it, it's too late. In most of the delivery situation, it happens like that. you understand the client differently, and the client gives you differently, and in between there is something. So in between you try to understand it and deliver something.
Yeah, I think that is covered in the point which we have mentioned as a skill gap, right?
No, I won't say skill gap, also understanding. I mean, your what to deliver, scope of the work. Skill gap is different. Skill gap is using the tool or functionality to bring into the system. But first of all, understanding the customer requirement itself, there is a huge mismatch.
Okay, okay. So because of that, I think the workload is increasing today. That's what
it is seemingly increasing. I won't say workload is increasing, never. If you put structure, yes, that means there is nothing structured available to deliver in the knowledge industry properly. You talk of a lot of things, but to deliver, who should deliver, which hours has to run this race? That is not clearly said.
Okay. So basically the right team is not in place for the right job. Is it right?
Team is not tuned and trained. Training is missing.
Training is a must. Training is necessary.
At any level. See, even today, I am putting myself into a learning process rather than saying I am a skilled and a knowledge, highly professional like that. I go through the material, learn it myself, ask a few questions, then only I will start my work. That is not happening today.
Exactly. Yep. Yep. I think that is exactly is what Ramya is using her skills to, train the people when they come into our Varna's house. They go through that because the first induction is that only in terms of what is the scope of learning. What is the scope of coverage, what we are offering? Am I right, Ramya?
Yes, sir, right.
Okay.
Sir, I have one question here.
Yeah, yeah.
With this COVID situation that we are all into, there is enormous changes that are happening in the way we learn things.
Okay.
And, especially the instructor-led training in a physical classroom versus what we are doing today virtually. When you talked about training, in fact, we are doing a lot of training virtually. And what is your perception and what is your reading about the effectiveness of the training in this manner, especially when we talk about hands-on training, kind of on-the-job training, with respect to that, how do you see this going with the new?
Even before COVID itself, the classroom training slowly drifted, and most of them wanted this webinar type of connection and get into knowledge gaining. So that way, even COVID will not impact, because already webinar is set in. So you have to expand that instead of a classroom session. I really see a day where there's no classroom, but everyone connects and get their knowledge well tuned through these mediums.
Which we are seeing it now.
Yeah, yeah. That is what is required.
Yeah.
As and
yes,
indeed.
Yes.
Yeah.
Most of the institutions are offering this online classes now, and most of the students are submitting their exercise or assignments through online. Absolutely right. And we are actually in the same direction.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have kind of a ready classroom, and where the teacher comes and where the teacher is submitting his the classwork he is submitting, and the students go through that, and there is a interactive session happens online, and they submit their assignments, and teacher gives the ratings for the respective assignments given by submitted by the student, and that's how student will know what are the strength areas and weak areas.
Yeah, that is very understandable. When will this entire classroom, putting every bunch of students into a classroom and instead a different type of approach to the learning itself from the school onwards, and that would be a great thing for us. We are all very analytical as Indians, very knowledgeable, but somebody has to inculcate that into the thing. And in fact, I still remember some of my teachers who taught me mathematics and all, but that kind of a thing is missing nowadays.
Oh, okay. Yep. So I think, you know, you, what you're saying is that the quality of the teaching methodology is also need to be focused.
That is right. All are brilliant. I see a lot of youngsters, but they have a lot of things to iron out. But iron out, who will do the ironing? Parents are restless on this. My son has to get 100. How will he get 100? How will he get into IT? I mean, straight away. I mean, but IT and from the institute to the organization, corporate, there's a huge gap. It is from the communication gap, technology gap, then also there is a understanding, and this person has to understand that, and this is what I'm going to. But peer pressure is very much impacting all of these guys to learn more. I mean, they don't learn, but peer pressure. Oh, he is knowing this, copy from him, then start working. That will not help. We should understand the basis. That basis understanding is missing. How do we corner this aspect? That is what the challenge for the industry. And every principal you go and talk, my guys are good. You, every HR selecting group you go and ask, oh no, I didn't get the best thing. You can't get the best person at all, never. Each one has a different way of approach. This is where a machine and a man differ. Man, each man is different, but a machine can be, 100 machine can be similar.
Okay. Yep. So, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Exactly. I think you have hit the nail. And what we are providing in our day-to-day online classes for various professionals is something. It is an innovative methodology of teaching them through case studies or various scenarios. So we build those scenarios and we tell them to configure the tool or the product to meet the demands of that particular situation. And that's how we bring those kind of a case studies, and we teach them through those situations, building those situations in our product. For example, if it is ERP or CRM, we give them various scenarios of the verticals, industry verticals, and we ask them to configure the product or, build any kind of a customized solution. So through that, I think we are able to really bring them the reality of the industry into their project. And they are going through that, and quickly they can learn.
See, that is one part of learning. But when they come out, before they come out of the college, you take a group and tell them, say, today you go and visit a factory. Most of them will go back, go to mall rather than a factory.
Industrial visit.
Industrial visit is a must. You must know where is the tool, where is the tooling. IT doesn't just say this. Just taking a few codes and writing will not give you an application. Today, most of the marketing guys are saying, I have an app. I have an app. You run this app, everything will be there. See, first of all, the input, the data input has to be there. You tell any guy, nobody will come for a factory visit. See, for example, you are saying that you are doing a lot of work for a sugar. Best industry to go and see. There's no waste. Nothing is wasted there. Everything is saleable. Apart from the sugar there. Molasses, you take anything there. Yep. It's saleable. Can't be a loss at all. You visit, a few visit there, give you a lot of insight for the IT guys. IT guys never put their shifting into this kind of focus. That is one of the lack of thing in the whole industry. Because that's where the gap creeps in.
I think it has to be driven by the institution and the faculty. Because you know, every we are talking about two levels. So one is the students who go through the educational institutions, and we are talking about other professionals who would like to add additional skills who are already working somewhere, you know. So that's where I think you have addressed that point also. You know, the people who are in the who are in this undergrads or grads, you know, that level you are talking about. So definitely there are much more challenges when you talk about the professionals, you know. So today if you visit any of these IT organizations or people who are into providing services, you know, they face these problems in terms of what is the workload. You know, if I go and ask my colleague today, and he or she will say, oh, I'm very busy. How busy, what busy is an issue, but they are not able to analyze. As a manager, I have to analyze and find out what is the additional skill required for her, so that, you know, she is able to meet the particular deadlines. That is something, you know, which I have to do. That is basically skill gap analysis. So on the other hand, there are various things are driving us. It could be digital transformation. There is it's basically tech driven. Every other competitor, every other organization is driving the digital transformation today. I have to ask myself as well as my team that whether are we ready to take up on this kind of a challenge? Are we ready to go with these new tools and the solutions? Is a question I have to ask. Over and above, I have to make a provision for it in terms of time. I have to make sure that the sufficient time is given for employees to upgrade their skills. They have to add additional skills. And these the number of hours they have to put in for education, I have to budget it. As well as, you know, at the same time, I have to make sure that the delivery deadlines are met. So these are further challenges for the top management level. I hope you got the point.
That's one thing. Even in the middle management, guys who are around age group of 35 to 45, their learning and upskilling doesn't stop. But they face a career crossroad and they don't want to upskill at all. I've spoken to many of those who come to me for asking, what do I do? Now I'm stuck in this. I always tell them, you don't stop saying that I've learned everything. Every 3 years in IT industry, there is some new tool. Every 1.5 years, there is something else is coming, upgrade in the OS. And that doesn't reach you at all if you don't make your hand dirty. And most of them don't feel like learning. That's a very problematic scenario. That's why we feel there is a shortage of skill. There's no shortage of skill. People are not willing to upgrade. That's a very sad scenario.
Right, right. So I also feel that there is good amount of challenge faced by the HR team in the organization today.
Correct.
Do we have a right HR person? Is a question. Do we have a right person?
See, nowadays what happens is people get into the organization as a techie. Then over a period of time, they feel that HR is a easy of staying in the organization. They organize and get switched over to HR role. HR role is not like that. It's a very, very vital role, which organizations are not properly understood so far. I make it that way.
Okay. Yeah. I think we also have to look at, as an organization, we also have to look at, you know, bringing the right people in the HR team is one, as well as, you know, they also have to upgrade their skills. while they do a filtering of the, you know, the resumes first, and while they talk to aspiring candidates, they need to be updated with the particular requirement as well as the tools which are used for delivering it. So HR team is not just, you know, getting the resumes. They need to really bring in their value added comments before they do, you know, in submitting the shortlisted resumes to the management or the delivery team.
Okay.
Yeah. So these challenges are there at HR level. Sorry, there is some echo.
Okay.
So coming to the other points are there in terms of challenges of there are latest things happening in cloud solution.
Okay.
Am I audible?
Okay, please. Yeah.
But now it is audible.
Okay, now it's okay. Yeah. So the question is that there are a lot of things happening in the cloud platform. And people are going and they are also adding more skills on the cloud solutions. Learnability is there, and the facilities also there. They would be able to quickly adapt those skills which are required for the job. And at the same time, organization has to really make a provision of giving these trainings through cloud. You know, today there are a lot of such solutions and tools available. I think organization has to learn how to bring in such new age of, you know, learning. New age of learning. Would you agree?
Yeah, that's right. It should always be a learning and delivering, not that you have expertise. That's how I always refrain from calling anyone expert or calling myself an expert in this particular. Because throughout my career, there has been a learning process every time, every year, the quantum of learning and whatever half learning or full learning. But learning has been there throughout my career. Even now, there is a learning for me to take up, say for example, internet things. It's a new thing for me. I have to read and find out what exactly the depth they are talking, or it is a old wine in a new bottle, which I have to see. You understand? Sometimes what happens, they put a old wine in a new bottle and say, this is how it is.
Yep, I agree with you. Yeah. See, Internet of Things is, to some extent, yes, it is old wine in new bottle, you know, except that, you know, the sensors were there, the collecting the data was there. Only the means of transferring the data into the server is done through the cloud. That's where, you know, this Internet of Things is taken up the shape. So we always know about the RTOSes, you know, real-time operating systems, RTOSes. And the connectors and sensors, we are always knowing about it, right? So you said, you know, it is something that it is not that great and it is not that new. But there is something called as a data analytics is merged with the RTOSes or sensors. So today, using these cloud services, you know, they are able to take the data into a cloud server. And once the data is captured into the server, they are able to apply the data analytics tools, and then they are able to take out the reports. So that's where the technology is existing today.
Okay, that's fine.
Any other points from Ramya? Ramya, you have some questions?
Yes, sir. Sir, I just wanted to know, post-COVID situation, according to the IT industries, okay, when we just pitch them for anything related to the new requirements or how exactly, because they tell us that let us wait till the market gets stabilized. In this situation, how we need to handle it? Any inputs from your end?
See, I would say it is a situation like a track runner, you know, suddenly fallen in the track. So how we will do? He won't get back to his own start point. He has to get up and run.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This situation is also like that. You have to get up and wait for whatever is coming and take the client's requirement where you left. From that point, you have to. It is not that you this will wait. I mean, nothing waits. It's a competition, correct? So you have to. See, I would in that context, I would tell you, India has faced quite a bit of these kind of dilemmas in the past also. There has been wars, there has been calamities like typhoid. This is nothing new, and it has been highly projected, very this one, you know, and all of us are finding it difficult. Those challenges in the past, say 1962, 65, 71, it was met very well, you know, with a strong arm. Today also it has been met. Probably another few months, all of us will gear up and start working. So probably they don't have an answer. That's why they are saying like that. Because you go to anyone, there's no answer. How to cure the corona, then nobody is able to tell you. Similar, doctor also not able to tell you. So that's why the customers are saying like that. And probably just to talk to you and tell you. Maybe you have to take it in good spirit and wait for the situation.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Sir, as per your present experience in IT domain and ERP domain, just want to have inputs from your end. How important is the technical-oriented job and functional-oriented job? And which domain holds good when we need to pitch for the customer or anything? How is the market? And all those things, can you just give me some inputs?
See, there are three levels. One is the pre-sales, correct? Yes. Second is the actual bid confirmation. And the third one is the implementation. And the last one is the final delivery, correct? Mm-hmm. You take each stage. When, suppose you are doing one ERP for a manufacturing. If you don't have the functional knowledge, if you won't tell them only your technical knowledge, mm-hmm. it will not help. You have to tell. Functionally, it will support everything here. So, if sugar industry, if you are implementing, the sugar industry expert has to be there, or the person who is knowledgeable about the sugar industry comes as a functional person to support the pre-sales. Correct. After pre-sales, when you have taken the order, then you have to scope your requirement. A technical person will say, I will handle like this if a data is given to me. Mm-hmm. He will not say what is the logic that should be built in and to get a data there, correct? Okay. So, functional and technical both are important at this point in time. How secure my data could be, a functional person cannot say, correct? Functional person will say, this is the requirement for me.
Right.
The third thing is implemented. Have I taken the process completely from you, from a manual or existing process, or an currently semi-automated to an automated, linked to all the requirements, third thing. Fourth is scrapping the old and running the new. Yeah. Right. Here also functionality and technical coordinate, you know, mm-hmm. they collaborate and work. So both are required at a percentage level. You may say 60% at some point, 50% at some point, and 100% at some point. Mm-hmm. It's okay? Clarified your...
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So basically what you said is that the both technical guys and the functional guys are required for large projects, and they go hand in hand, and you know, they play their roles to optimize the delivery time and make sure that they finally meet the requirement and fulfill. Absolutely right.
Correct.
So
correct.
So COVID has given us a large very good opportunity in terms of you know, work from home, as well as work from wherever we are there. You know, if I'm there in the factory side, or I can be there, or if my developers are there in at home, they are doing it. So that has really given us a good opportunity to work together is one. Basically, online collaboration is what we are doing today. And we have set up processes to capture all those minutes and discussions and various, you know, the process we have already followed. For example, part of the project is already done, so it is captured in the records. And if something is going through UAT or inspection, yes, that is also being captured. And something is already gone live, and that is also being captured. So every level of project implementation, we have implemented through certain tools and mechanisms so that we have reduced a lot of manual operation. We have automated several operations so that we are there on time and meeting all that 100% of the requirement. That's what we have learned. And it has really helped. COVID situation has really helped us to optimize our time. So we have reduced our travel cost. We have reduced our travel time. And any fatigue, what our people go through, everything is reduced. And that has helped us to improve our productivity here. That's an added advantage for us. I hope, you know, this we will be able to use for the ongoing projects in future also. So that, you know, we optimize our productivity and the deliverability as well as learnability.
Yes, sir.
Look at a scenario. Husband and wife working in an IT company, and both of them are working from home. The bandwidth will be a basic problem to support from home. So this bandwidth issue, network issue, then the security of the domain, I mean applications, and all these are concern which the organization has to address. Simply saying that work from home is not a criterion at all. Data going, see, husband and wife, okay, they can't share data, correct? The two companies, two different companies.
Yeah, this is.
Yes,
one,
sir.
Correct. Yeah, they can't share.
Yeah, how are you going to address this issue? And plus bandwidth. And most of them don't have power shutdown criteria at all. So how you waste of time there?
Okay, I think the current infrastructure at Indian home is much improved compared to earlier days.
No. And just you are talking about your self. Okay. You go see outside. A lot of people are still not got the internet working 24 hours.
Sir, this is such a valid point. I'll tell you, if there are, you know, imagine there are two kids who are attending the school online, and both parents are working.
Okay.
And the kids also, you know, watch their, there are old, you know, parents want to entertain themselves on using internet. And imagine, I mean, this kind of, you know, in fact, I was part of the teachers in a parent meeting today, and these were the points we were discussing, like, you know, bandwidth issue, two kids sharing, that they have only one desktop for kids. I mean, suddenly these are all new requirements that have come into a family.
Oh yeah, correct.
Yeah, I won't prefer a home to be a office all day, all time.
Okay.
I would need definitely a line drawn between an office then a thing. See, it's not going to help or save anything. They will revert. It's easy to say, but implementing the noise, you know. See, when you are working in an office, noise is not heard. Road noise or a drum beat from a school behind your house doesn't help. Somebody puts the kettle on, and your prestige cooker is whistling. All these are nuisance which you will be hearing in a meeting. The meeting is not pleasant then. The dog barks.
Yep, yeah, I agree with you. Yeah. All those are major issues to be.
These are all fundamental, and it can't stay with the system. How are you going to address this? See, I worked from home. But I still found that your neighbors come and ask you, ಇವತ್ತು ವಾಪಸ್ ಹೋಗಿಲ್ವಾ ನೀವು.
Yeah, yeah. So there is a lot of disturbance from other point.
Yeah, I thought. Why you not gone to office?
I think on top of it, what could happen? I mean, what is happening? I have also seen that, you know, the manager will start calling at a, you know, different office hours also. The manager thinks that, you know, my person is always available. So when work from home, you know, time sensitivity is not there. You know, time discipline is not maintained.
That is the problem. Time sensitivity will be lost, totally lost. You can't call a lady who's managing both home and thing after 8 o'clock have a meeting. On the though it is a video call, very difficult for them to manage, and the child will not see you. I mean, always seeing you working. Child will not appreciate mom doing it, pop doing it like this. It is not only for mom. Pop also has a problem.
Correct. The work from home is another big challenge for HR team also. You know, how do they bring the bondage between people? The bonding between organization and people would get really hurt. If somebody works from home, there is no discipline, there is no kind of a feeling loyalty or keeping in touch with peers.
That is very important. If I don't see my peers, if I don't see my peers, it's not a good time. I must see my peers.
They are different new age HR issues to be handled.
See, another thing, no, most of the companies go through an audit process in a year. Correct. Say certification, compliance, all these are there. Auditors will never be comfortable auditing over a mic. Correct. They would physically want to see that person. So how will this process going to be implemented? This is a great challenge. Then I can't take ISO. ISO says, by location only you are satisfied. Suppose you have put all your 3 lakhs people into some kind of a work from home situation. That means to say that you have to be certified 3 lakhs times.
Oh.
This is a location.
Okay. Yeah. This is good. I mean, good thought actually. The organizations have to really think twice before, you know, pushing for work from home. Fully agree.
Okay.
Any other points, Dinesh, you may have before we close the call? Or any other points from Ramya also?
I think, you know, these are new points, really. New thoughts are coming to really very fruitful.
I really don't know whether the government would do something to address this work from home issues. Government may not think about it right now. They are busy in giving solution for the COVID itself. But at the same time, you know, they have to look at the industries working and situations to avoid any kind of collapse in the economy. All that they have to really see.
No, I think, you know, one good thing that is happening with work from home is, there are so many people not committing to work. Less traffic, comparatively less pollution, and especially look at people traveling from areas like Vijayanagar or JP Nagar to Whitefield every day, spending 6 hours in a car versus working from home. It's a huge saving. That's one positive side of it. But other, again, there are many flip sides. But when you look at IT industry, this work from home is feasible. But what about many jobs which cannot be done work from home? There are many jobs
there. Yeah, factory setup, you can't work from home. Factory, you can't give a machine to everyone to work from home. You have to go to the factory.
Yep. No, but even it could be useful, beneficial for only those developers. You know, if there is something that to be done on the back end of the office, like people working on the security issues, people working on the servers, you know, maintaining server health and all that. You know, they have to be inside the office. Otherwise, how many of your VPNs could work and how many of things would really, I really don't know. Just 1 second.
Hello. Yeah.
Can I call you back? I'm in the meeting now.
Yeah, I'm here. Sure. Hello?
Yeah.
I'm here.
Ramya, go ahead. You have any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. So, if it's okay, Varadarajan sir and Dinesh sir, can we close the call now?
Yeah, wonderful. Yeah, that's right.
It's really wonderful. Thank you for your time. Both of you have really, you know, spent your time on this call and shared a lot of inputs about the challenges faced by IT organizations during the COVID time and post-COVID. What are the challenges can be addressed? How it can be addressed? Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
We'll keep in touch with you.
Yeah. Please go ahead.
Sir, one last thing, you know, one last request here. In the next call, maybe, like, you know, we need your suggestions on our, you know, for especially for rural kids. We operate it, as you know, Anand was saying. We run a program called Tare Zameen Par, which is a mobile planetarium. So, just before the lockdown, like, you know, we were growing at a very rapid speed, almost 50% growth rate. And we were spreading across geographies, about to get into Jammu, Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and many other places. But this has really landed us in a very, very tricky situation. What we would like to is, you know, we'd like to present what we're doing during the next call and need your inputs on how we repackage the whole thing and present it.
Okay, let's see.
Yeah. Thank you.
Nice knowing you, Dinesh. Nice knowing you. Very nice to be on the call. Yeah.
Yeah, please.
So we'll take it forward. How best it should be useful. That's what.
Yeah.
Yes. Yep. Thank you so much from my end, and thank you all, including Ramya. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Have a good day.
Thank you, Ramya.
All of you. Thank you, sir. Bye, sir. Bye.